12.
Whoa! Careful! We don't want to have a glass over it.
Glass over.
Wait, Richard.
Thank you so much. The mother of all trees.
That tree got notched on top,
the top of
the stump.
That's huge. That's weird. Like, why would they do
that? Yeah, why would they do that? Look at that tree going over there to that.
Oh, yeah, it's going right over.
I remember the first time I came to BC, I couldn't believe the trees. Coming from Saskatchewan, we hardly had any trees at that time,
yeah.
Let alone these big monsters. I saw the huge trees for the first time in my life.
Right.
I only saw them in pictures before. And I was so awed by them. I couldn't get over it. And then also cherries growing on trees. Hello. All I ever saw growing was wheat.
Yeah.
Anyways.
You can see the early growth years are heavy and thick.
Right.
There. Like they're almost quarter inch wide.
Yeah.
1/8 inch for sure. As it gets older, narrower, tiny. Here they're extremely tiny. We're talking maybe a 1/64 of an inch.
Yeah.
And all the way through to here.
Yeah.
How many hundreds of rings we have. I'm not this old.
Are you enjoying yourself?
I am. It's so beautiful
here. How's the forest looking today?
Wonderful. And smell. Oh, it's just beautiful. It's all earthy.
Makes you want to live here, doesn't it?
You know what? Yes.
I fall in the turnbuckle. As far as I'm coming.
Come on. Come on.
I'm not doing
that. Don't be afraid. Well, you won't fall in the water. Come on. Let's go all the way to the end.
I'm not coming out.
Go to the end.
I'm not coming out.
Go to the end.
I'm not coming out.
Whoa!
That's really interesting. Don't you think?
Yeah. Absolutely.
This is a surreal world. I feel I'm in some kind of wonderland of scary things.
Scary.
Well, look at them. Does that look scary to you?
It looks beautiful to me.
Beautiful, but it's a little bit not so. Well, I see characters every time I see something like this. This looks like a fox.
Oh, right.
See? So it's like some kind of wonderland here. Except we haven't seen any live life except the trees and the people. No animals.
Well, because there's too many people.
You think?
Probably. Oh. Yeah, animals won't be near this place because of the parking lot. Cars, people, everything, every day, all day.
There's plenty of space for
them. At night, you'll have animals.
You think they're all hiding in there somewhere? Look, even squirrels. Squirrels aren't afraid of people. Come on.
Nah, but they don't want to be around them. They'll avoid them.
In the city they are.
That's different. These are not city squirrels. These are wild squirrels.
I guess everybody's wild here and they don't like us.
Oh, there's a mushroom. Look.
Oh,
a tiny little mushroom.
Tiny little mushroom.
There's another one there.
Yeah.
Are you taking the elevator up, Jerry?
There's a fire in here.
Yeah. That's why it's hollow.
Amazing. Yeah. It's way up there too.
Look at all the mothers.
They told me a little girl did this.
They're very nice.
Yeah, they are. See that beautiful rock there? Yeah. I'd like to take it.
You can't.
Why?
Because we don't need any more rocks.
Yeah, but not. We don't have rocks
yeah,
that color.
Yeah, we do. If you go around our yard, you'll find rocks.
That color?
Mine. Whoa! Your glass has exploded.
Somebody white water rafting down there?
Woo. So how was your walk, girls?
Oh, good. Beautiful.
Very warm, but very good.
Nice. Quite comfortable. Oh. Looks like a beautiful lunch you made, little Louie.
That's a wrap.
Richard, you should make these.
$10
each.
Looks like it asks me for the art stuff.
That's great.
You know, like this is the cutoff of a 2x2.
Yeah, I know. I got all kinds of...
Well, this is not... This is heavy. It's not wood.
So that's clay or something.
It's cement.
Oh, cool. What do you do with lavender?
You put it in with your undies in the drawer and your undies smell good.
Okay, so why am I in here?
I have no idea.
Richard, Ginger says that you put the lavender under your undies in your drawer.
So that's been my problem all
right.
My life. If only I had known when I was capable of actually doing something about it.
It would have been a lot better.
I know it would have been. Just think how it would have changed my life.
And ours.
And yours too.
Ginger tells me that lavender is something you put under your undies in your drawer.
Yes.
If you're a lady.
Well, she didn't specify who would do this.
Well, can you?
So what about, are you interested in this?
Do you like the lavender crotch or do you? Don't you?
Hey,
I don't know. I never heard of such a thing.
We use a special cutter that...
Could always use a garlic bulb.
I'm not heavy processing.
Or two.
No, listen to me. It jumped into the tub and washed away.
He's not listening.
Oh my goodness, this is funny.
You're the goose whisperer.
I'm the goose whisperer. I was kind of giving them what for, right?
The goose lecturer.
He's got real muddy feet, and all he's doing is taking water out of there and fluffing up his feathers a little bit. And he makes a lot of noise.
What you got? That was pretty special, eh?
Yeah, look at this crab.
Here, Norm. I just chased this one out of
the pool. There's one right there. It went down the hole.
Climb up her legs.
No, they won't.
Norm, there's one right here.
So. Okay.
I chased him out of that shell.
There's a guy in there.
Is there?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, there is.
Look at him. Ginger. What is it? He's in there.
Oh, yeah. A tiny little shell.
All of this seaweed here that you see, they've all got rocks in that attached to it.
Here, Jen. Fine. You take this home with you. Oh.
Clam dinner. Ginger doesn't like seafood,
though. I don't like seafood.
Sometimes when you're walking, if you feel something spray on your leg,
yeah.
You've stepped on a crab.
Do that again.
Sand dollar.
That's cool. Now go spend it.
Yeah.
Whoa, that's cool. That's very slick. What are you going to do with it?
I'm going to wash it off and clean it.
It's a part of an oyster shell. And these were such a pretty purple, and you know at my age.
Yeah.
Purple is supposed to be your color. And then this little one I'll open, see if it's worthwhile.
The beachcombers.
Yep. That's us. Yep. Liked it. Loved it.
Thought this was garbage.
It is. Put your fingers in. Push the thing up. Push the little lock. No, put your fingers in further. There you go. Where are we and what are we doing?
Ask her.
We are at Elk Falls Provincial Park and we're going to the suspension bridge and falls.
Are we going to fall from the bridge?
You are.
Is that why they call it the falls?
It's the Norm Falls Over Bridge.
Are you excited about this day?
Sure, I'm excited every day.
Are you going to go on the bridge?
Oh yeah.
Are you not scared?
Oh, I don't think so.
Wait till you see it.
Oh, okay. Might change my mind.
You might change your mind.
So if you go on the bridge,
yeah,
you go across and then you have to come back again.
I guess so.
Wow.
I have no idea. But we'll find out.
Okay. over here, and we're going to come along. We have to make a loop, yeah. And we're going back. And here is the bridge, I think.
Okay.
Maybe it's a steep hill or something down to the water.
There's probably a lot of climbing and stuff.
We'll see when we get there.
Here we are.
Suspension bridge, and down there is the viewing station to see the falls.
Okay.
So,
what should we do?
Let's go, people.
Okay. We're gonna watch you, and if nothing happens to you,
then you'll follow.
Then we'll follow.
Okay.
Okay, go. Okay. I think it's safe enough to actually do this, guys. One step at a time, please. Good.
Who's shaking that?
Nobody.
You are.
Not me.
Look down there.
It's beautiful. I just love it. It's designed so well so that you get such a good view of the water, the trees.
What do you think of those little blue flowers down there?
Very nice.
So you made it all the way up.
I did.
And now it's kind of anticlimactic, I guess.
Yeah, but you're right, because it doesn't swing. Where are those bridges?
I was a little disappointed. I was hoping that it would be one of those old-fashioned rope ones.
Yeah, well,
be more fun.
This is much safer.
A bit too safe, maybe.
Yeah, well.
Oh well. Now we go back.
Scrape it on, lift it away, and then I'll go and hit it with, you know, the gold or another color to make it stand out. These are actually from napkins. Then I went in here and where all of the, it's ripped up, so it's not making the exact design of the napkin, but all the colors. And then I just went in and highlighted with them.
The process is the same regardless of the size.
Yeah.
So even these small ones, the process is exactly the same.
And then I decide where am I seeing my figures? What am I seeing? And then I kind of paint around the background. This is my work in progress. It is from my wildflower series. It is number 2. I've only done one other one because these are too hard. Actually, this has been worked on for a long time because I'm still not really happy with it. I repainted the vase out with gesso because I didn't like it, so I'm starting again. It's a lot of work, but I think it'll work out in the end. My sister, my lovely sister,
older sister,
has admired my cow, and I have decided that I will gift her my cow because she wanted to buy it. And I decided not to take any money, but she's sad now, so I'm gonna take $1.
And Jennifer, what do you think of that?
Oh, I'm lost for words, I'm sorry. That is, I love a lot of them, but this cow seemed to touch me, and there's something special about Daisy. And I certainly can see there's something very special about our sister Lois. I had no idea. Oh, that's enough. I hope that when you're cleverly editing this, the last thing, the last frame is me saying,
that's a wrap.
I wonder if I hadn't already thought of that. But yes, I'm sure it just might be, it might be a good way to end everything.
Yeah.
I don't know. What do you think?
That's a wrap.